spent the last 2 years writing songs and recording demos and just kind of like trying to focus on writing better songs, creating better arrangements together, rather than rushing into following up our last album. I think it's definitely paid off for us to kind of leave the past behind us and try to forge ahead with a new sound, something a bit more honest, something simpler, and certainly from my perspective, singing in more of my own voice and writing about themes and subjects that kind of relate more to my life rather than like projecting like my surroundings. I think I'm trying to focus on being more truthful to myself and to the kind of music I want to make and the kind of music that I do make.
Wrote a song about crying myself to sleep. No one listened to the only sound I could keep. Well, they say my misery sells. Well, I'm not convinced. That's the only way I'll make myself whole, I think.
There's a couple of aspects of the EP that were like a bit cheeky or sort of celebrating the humour in like sad themes or something like that. Like, it's a kind of song about like conforming to like what people in the music industry who work in the music industry who are like fanatic about the industry. It's kind of like that thing about like telling them like, oh, this is what you should do, this, and I kind of like my I suppose one of the poppiest songs in the EP was my reaction to like being told what to do. I feel like that was another thing that like came from the last records campaign. Like, I took a lot of like resentment towards like the music industry and the media and stuff like that, and I kind of like just channeled it through. So there's a kind of aspects of the EP where I've been a bit more cheeky or of like, you know, just trying to embrace a bit of humour in things, you know. Like, I think there's a great element in being expressive about sadness, but on the other hand, you can't just like express just one emotion. The difficulty came when just getting to the point where I could write songs. A lot after the last album, I was kind of finding myself suffering from like depression and like other kind of personal issues that weren't like conducive to me wanting to write. Like, I had a bad job and I found myself on the sort of more downward spectrum of like emotions, to the point I couldn't find anything that I'd want to write about. All the mechanisms and like sort of methods I used to use to write music weren't available to me anymore, and it was just a point where I had to like write about what came from inside, because that was just like what was screaming to come out. One of the greatest compliments you can ever have is like someone coming up after a show or like coming up to the street and saying, this song means a lot to me, I totally recognise what you're talking about in the song and it speaks to me. So I think the only way I found that I could do that with music was to be able to speak from my own heart and my own experiences. If you're going to do it, you can't like eat around the edges. You only have to go straight for the core of it, you know. And I think that's what I've tried to do with these new songs.
You leave me much stronger. Now the road is much longer. I stand looking outward. Weep up the bridge you're walking on. To never realize the time was on your. stronger. Now the road is much longer. I stand here looking at words. We built the bridge you're walking on. You leave me much stronger. Now the road is much longer. I stand here looking at words. We built the bridge you're walking on.
Time from the since the start of the band, there was this core four guys in the band and our manager, and over the course of the years the relationships have professionally have just we've kind of drifted apart. Certainly with our drummer, he was an integral part of the band, but I think it got to the point where it just wasn't working in a productive way. And there were just ideas that we didn't see eye to eye on, and it just got to the point where the best thing for the band was to make a change. It was strange to have such a big change in the band, to lose and part ways with an original member, and then a couple of months later to part ways with our manager who I'd worked with for about 8 years. So we kind of feel a wee bit like we're out on our own, it's quite daunting, in some respects, because there's a lot of aspects to running the band that we haven't been involved with for a while. But I'm kind of taking all positives from that. I'm kind of quite excited that we're gonna continue running the band independently. It feels fresher, I think, even though one of the songs on the EP, The Bridge, is certainly about being split from an old life or an old way of doing things and forging ahead anew. The last time we did a record, that there was I didn't get as much of the love, or I kind of lost a bit of my sort of passion for writing music, or just being in a band and doing things. And now I feel like I've got more passion, I've got more opportunity to get my teeth stuck into things and be more involved with my career. Because if you don't focus on how much you enjoy doing something, then there's no point in doing it, I think.
I'll be the man one day. Right now I am lucky. Luckiest wings on, I fly all the time. Tearing you apart just to see what's inside. All the love for all the time. Take it all for granted.
It's liberating to sing in my own voice. I don't know why I didn't do it in the first place. I think it sounds more like me. I feel like at first, when the suggestion was made that I should try and sing in my own accent, I was like, what are you talking about? But now I see it and I understand and I can hear it, that it makes more sense. And it relates more to the way I've been writing songs as well, because I'm a 28-year-old Glaswegian guy writing songs about being miserable or happy or in a kind of fuck you kind of way. The whole ethos behind Three Blind Wolves moving forward is just trying to be fresh and new and a bit more modern and certainly Scottish, and just trying to be as honest as possible, I think, from a songwriting point of view. It's the best thing we've ever done. It's the start of a new chapter in the band. And every time, if we do the next few records like the way we've done this one, and or better, then I'll enjoy making music.
When we take our time,